warm welcome to the Lake Placid Olympic Ski Jumping Complex, an iconic location from the Olympic Games, and we'll be adding to its rich sporting history over the next hour or so with some more top-class competition. It's day three of competition in the Nordic Combined, and it's the men's team sprint today. After the jumping here, the competition moves to Mount Hovenberg for the cross-country race. Slightly warmer conditions than we've experienced in recent days, 3 degrees. But more importantly, there is very little breeze. Well, we're on the 90-metre hill this afternoon here at Lake Placid. If you're new to the sport, that means you get 60 points for landing on that 90 metres line. That's the one, the red line furthest up the hill. And 2 points extra for every metre beyond that, 2 metres less, and you lose 2 points. We've got 7 teams of 2 athletes starting. Each athlete will jump once. 5 nations represented. As you can see, Japan and USA have 2 teams entered. Right now, it's Motoki Yamanaka of Japan. His teammate is Kazuho Kodate. He'll go second, but all eyes now on Yamanaka. Good jump. Solid landing. And he's just hit 84.5 metres distance. Looking down the list, I'd say that on average the better jumpers choose to go second, the better jumper of the pair. Aman Kelduli of Kazakhstan. Just 19 years old. That was a good spring off the table, and it was a good length as well. Yeah, 85 meters. That is the longest jump of the competition so far. So 85 meters distance and a total of 99, that puts Kazakhstan in second place. And that's Vitaly Rebenyuk. And their tactic was very simple when I spoke to their coach. It's just go for it. Go for it in both the ski jumping and in the cross country. Good clean jump. Pretty good distance as well, 86 meters. So he's just registered the longest jump of the competition so far. And the judges liked it as well. They've given him some good points, some 16 and a half. Total of 103.9, and that puts Ukraine in the driving seat. This is Evan Nichols. This is his home hill. He knows it well. He trains here on a regular basis, studies at Vermont Community College, and 2 times junior USA champion. A good jump, good length. Just short of the K point, 88.5 meters. But did the judges like the style? Looked fully in control, hips bent, good position. The judges agree, they've marked him up. Got a couple of 18s there, and a total of 111.3, and that's good enough to take the lead. And here is the first Japanese jumper of their second team, Takuya Nakazawa. Solid jump from him. Now he has teamed up with Sakutaro Kobayashi, who will jump second. And Kobayashi has already proven himself as a great ski jumper. taking two gold medals already in the Nordic combined. And I suspect Nakazawa's job will be to get around the cross-country course and help Kobayashi to keep up with the American sprinters. So 95.6 for him. So USA 1, Ukraine and Japan 2, first, second and third. 11 points separating first from third. Kazuho Kodate. That was a good launch, good positioning through the air, short jump, mind you, 83 meters. As you watch the replay, you can see his legs straight out, his ankles turned up. That's what the judges are looking for. And they've marked him appropriately, a couple of 17s. That gives him a total of 195.8. Now, this is the youngest of the Nordic combined competitors, Ali Askar of Kazakhstan. Clean jump. And he's impressed. He's impressed by his steely nerves. Many of that age in their first big international competition would be intimidated by the hill and the his opponents. Just a little bit wobbly just before landing. And marked down appropriately by the judges. So 69.5, bringing him to 168.5. Still good enough to move Kazakhstan into second place. Dmytro Mazurchuk of Ukraine, 23 years old, already hugely experienced. He represented his country at Beijing last year, the Olympic Games. Let's see what he can do here. Well, a nice landing, poised flight from him, 86.5 the distance, 107.2, bringing Ukraine to 211.1, and that puts them top of the leaderboard. Two jumpers still to go. Nicholas Malasinski of the USA. He already has two silver medals at these games in the individual Gunderson and the mass start. Can he and his teammate go one better here and make it gold? Nice control and a nice long jump as well. I think it was just short of the 90 meter mark. 86.5 for Malasinski, who has put in a couple of amazing cross-country races, some really good performances on the track. And that score brings them to 216.8, and the USA go top of the leaderboard. But now comes Sakutaro Kobayashi. And I was talking to him earlier, he was pretty confident because he said the conditions are just as he likes them. Kobayashi showing real poise and experience. Just trying to keep those skis level. And you see what I mean about being a big jumper? 99.5, just half a meter off that 100 meter red line. And with a jump of that length, well, you've just got to be of average points, really, from the judges for your style. It brings their total to 235.8. So Sakutaro Kobayashi has done it. He has put Japan top of the leaderboards. 235.8 points, a big separation from USA 1. Then come Ukraine in third, Japan two in fourth, Kazakhstan in fifth. So here we go with a final round of the Nordic combined men's team sprint, eight laps of a 1.5 kilometer track. Each of the two-man teams, each member of the team, will race four laps. Then they come into the stadium at the end of each lap. They tag their teammate and set them off as well. First to go is Takuya Nakazawa. He gets this race underway, and you can start counting the seconds. 25 seconds from now, Evan Nichols will go, representing the USA. And the Americans, we know, are really good sprinters. They've proved themselves already in previous races here in the Nordic combined, in the Gundersen and in the mass start. So can Evan Nichols start to reel in that 25-second gap off Nakazawa? Mazurchuk of Ukraine is out next. Then comes the Japan 2 team. Kazuho Kodate will go next. Quite a gap to him. They start a minute and 30 seconds between behind Nakazawa. And we're looking for just over 3 minutes a lap. And already Nakazawa has completed that first lap. And so Kobayashi, whose strength is ski jumping, now heads off and tries to keep that gap alive. And here we go. The Americans have lost time on the Japanese already. So they tag, they have to touch their teammate. Time difference of 30.4 seconds. They've lost 5 seconds already. So Japan are beginning to pull away on that after that first lap. And Malasinski has made up time on the Japanese. We'll get confirmation of exactly what that is when he comes and tags his teammate, but he was 5 seconds up on him at the 900 meter mark on that second lap. So Japan won onto their third lap with Nakazawa. And here we go, the all important tag that tells us there is a time difference of 20.6 seconds. So they've reeled them in. Mazurchuk takes up the running for Ukraine. Our leader is still Japan 1. Kobayashi, off he goes. This is his second lap.
The rains have dissipated, but the fog has moved in. You can see it up in the halogen lights as Kobayashi now.
Now, 16 seconds again, now between Japan 1 and USA 1. We're not halfway through the race yet. Ukraine, 29 seconds behind the leaders. They've lost time on second placed USA. Up this hill. And you can see how close the Americans are now. Malasinski has cut that gap to 12 seconds. So he's halved the starting time. Rebenyuk, 26.9. So still staying in touch with the leading pair. Certainly not out of it. Ukrainians looking for their first medal of these games. And meanwhile, the Japanese looking to add to their tally of 7 four of them gold, and this man's won two of them in the mass start and the individual Gunderson. But does he have the puff to stay ahead of Malasinski? He does now, but we've still got half the race to go as he tags Takuya Nakazawa. And there's the difference between them, down to 7.3 seconds.
7 seconds, this gap is closing quickly now. Evan has him.
Evan Nichols. Very experienced already. He's got a number of junior national titles. Been part of the American national team for a couple of years now. If this continues as it is doing, this race, then they won't have done enough because the Americans are closing the gap and they're closing that difference fast. Each lap, that's each 1.5 kilometer lap, 54 meter is the total climb. And look at him, he has now closed the gap as we come to this 900 meters checkpoint, just down to 2 seconds. They are now neck and neck. Nakazawa just holding the lead, but for how long? Nichols has really pulled out the stops on this fifth lap.
Smart move coming into this stage. The long backstretch, you can really slingshot off another athlete.
Now you've got to, as you come into the stadium, you've got to kind of, you've got to sort of balance the speed and staying upright, because a fall would be potentially catastrophic here. You don't want to risk a breakage as well. He's got to stay on his feet as they come in now to the home straight. And the tag coming up, and the USA have taken the lead at the fifth exchange. A terrific round from Evan Nichols, an excellent lap from Nichols. And he tags his teammate Malasinski, who we know is even faster. And now suddenly Kobayashi, whose job from the start was just to stay ahead, well, his job now is to chase. Malasinski and Kobayashi. It's cat and mouse all the way. The Kazakhstani keeps out of the way. And really, there's nothing to separate the two teams going into the next lap. The pressure is on for Nakazawa and for Nichols. Evan Nichols, off he goes then, out in front, but only just.
Out there, but it's going to be a decision of when to do it. They're not.
We'll just give you some splits from the other teams as they come into the stadium. There'll be Ukraine now 30 seconds behind this leading pair. And this is where the skiers will be hoping that their technicians have prepared their skis perfectly. And they'll probably put some ridges in motorsport terms, they'll be on their wet weather tires. They have the ridges to displace the sort of surface water. And that could very well make the difference with the race being so close. And Kobayashi pushes it to the tag point, to the exchange point. Nakazawa, I should say, completes his lap and sets off Kobayashi. A really good run from Nakazawa, who stayed in touch with the American Evan Nichols. And now it's just down to these two.
I need to save something. I need to make sure that I've either got something for the end or I'm going to leave it on the course.
It's Kobayashi up against Malasinski. Niklas Malasinski has proved many times on this circuit that he has it in him, that he's fast. And he's taken the lead, and Malasinski goes ahead again, the second time he's taken the lead in this race. And now, can he grow that lead? Vital for Kobayashi to stay in touch, to stay on his shoulder. Ukraine now 37 seconds behind in third place, but have a good advantage. So are likely to take the bronze. Here they come up the hill to the checkpoint. And look at that, he's left the Japanese behind. Kobayashi is struggling on the hill and Malasinski pulls away. And now he goes downhill and that is going to increase the gap as Kobayashi tries to reach the summit. Now he just needs to stay safe, stay on his skis. And there he has it. He picks his lane. He's on the home straight. His teammate raises his arms aloft. And Malasinski skis across the finish line to take the USA's first gold medal in Nordic combined. Silver will go to Japan. And Sakutaro Kobayashi, who put in a fantastic jump. So it's going to be bronze for the Ukraine. Well done to Mazurchuk and Rebenyuk. So as the Americans celebrate. The other American team, USA 2, have managed to reel in their opponents. And now Aiden Ripp has managed to work his way up into fourth place. And they've really put in a great performance, USA 2, Henry Johnston and Aiden Ripp, as the second Japanese team come in with Yamanaka. And concluding Poland's race will be Krzyszkowicz, 2 minutes and 23 seconds behind the winners. So confirmation of the results then, USA 1 taking gold, Japan 1 taking second, and Ukraine taking third place.
And Niklas Malasinski!
So Japan add to their medal tally of seven in total, but the night belongs to two young men from the USA, Evan Nichols and Niklas Malasinski, who have finally got a gold medal for the USA's Nordic combined team here at the FISU Winter Games in Lake Placid.